He was a man of faith, man of love, man of charity, good educator, orator, and above all, a good teacher who tried to instill good values in all those whom he encountered in his lifetime. As students of St. Gaspar Vidyalaya, we are very proud to have this institution under his patronage, protection and care. He was an apostle of the precious blood, a little flower which bloomed in the large garden of Rome, and a saint of the people. He was born of a good Christian couple, Antonio del Bufalo and Annunziata Quattroni, on 6th of January 1786 in Esquilin Hill of Rome. At the age of 2, Gaspar became very sick and was about to lose his eyesight due to the bout of smallpox. His mother Annunziata, after trying every remedy at her disposal, turned, as it is often done in desperate situations, through the intercession of St. Francis Xavier. His cure was immediate and total.
Gaspar, I think your mother is cooking for you.
Oh, and Dad. Mama, I am here.
Oh, my son. What were you doing? I was looking for you.
I was helping Dad and arranging the table for his mother's food.
How nice of you, my son. Prepare yourself, my son. We shall go to church.
Sure, Mom. I will be ready in your time.
Good, Danny. Pray for me.
Son, today you are alive and able to see the beautiful creation of God only because of this faith. You need to thank him for the gift of life.
Gaspar's first concern was for the poor and the children of the poor people. His first apostolate occurred among the farmers, shepherds and the unemployed. He loved them and defended them through numerous sacrifices, struggles and persecution.
Thank you.
No.
But they are happy than me. Indeed, I am very happy to see
you. I love you, my child. God bless you. We are really proud to have son like this.
Gaspar received a special permission to wear priestly habit, namely cassock, at the age of 10. He entered the seminary on April 12, 1800. On February 21, 1807, he became a subdeacon and worked in St. Mark's Church. On March 12, 1808, he was ordained as a deacon, and on July 31, 1808, he was ordained as a priest. As young priest, Gaspar worked among the hucksters for their conversion. Gaspar had deep desire to come to India, following the footsteps of St. Francis Xavier, to take example of missionary by Francis Xavier.
Your Holiness, if Your Highness permits me, I wish I could go for mission work in India.
Gaspar, I'm very happy to know about your interest. Perhaps if I see you.
Your Holiness, I prefer to obey your word than in fulfilling my desire.
My joy overflows at your words. Looking at a desire to take up mission, I would prefer you to stay and work among the brigands here in Rome.
With joy, Your Holiness.
Really, he's an angel.
Brothers, what are you doing? Why this injustice against human?
एक बात
है
Gaspar, what do you want? Mind your work.
We know intention.
Brothers, God created everyone with His own image and likeness, and gave example love one another as with the same love. Come with me, I will show how God loves us. They are our brothers. We don't have rights to harm them. No, brother, listen to me. I will try to get all the necessary help for better life. Why don't you give up the dark life? Come to the light.
Padre Gaspar, we will listen to you.
Thanks be to God. Come with me.
This is how the brigands were helped to change their way of life and start a new way of life. In the year 1809, May 17, Napoleon proclaimed an end to the temporal power of Pope. He arrested the cardinals who refused to obey the orders of him. Gaspar too was summoned to appear at the army office on 13 June 1810.
Are you the Gaspar?
Yes, I am. What can I do for you?
Listen, if you want to continue as priest, you must show the allegiance to Napoleon, not to the Pope.
What?
Yes, you must.
No way.
Bring his father here. Antony, tell your son obey the order of Napoleon. If not, he may have to face the consequences.
Citizen, I am your father. I am a short cost, I have done my son, but don't speak to me as bearing allegiance.
Damn it! Gaspar, last chance for you.
I cannot, I must not, I will not.
Seize him!
Gaspar was arrested and was imprisoned for 4 years. During this time, he prepared himself to face the life situations and gathered a like-minded priest to start the congregation. In the year 1814, Napoleon was defeated and he lost his power on Rome. The Pope, all the priests and cardinals who were imprisoned were set free. After the prison experiences in the year 1815, August 15, Gaspar officially started the congregation which is known as Missionaries of the Most Precious Blood. Maria di Matias was a young girl from Malacosa who was very much interested in listening to sermons of Gaspar and drew the inspiration from him to dedicate herself of the mission of Christ. Gaspar helped her to realize her dream by providing an advisor from the congregation, namely John Merlini.
Oh Maria, welcome. I heard about you from Merlin. Interesting to know about your dreams.
Father Gaspar, help me fulfilling my dream.
Sure Maria, I am sending Father Merlin to help you, guide you in all the steps that you are taking for opening society.
Father John, helper and guider.
Yes, Father, I do.
Thus, with the constant support and guidance of Gaspar and Merlini, Sister Maria di Matias started a congregation which is known as Adorers of Precious Blood. This is how the two societies were born to help the needy of the society. Today, these societies are grown as huge trees, spreading their branches all over the world. Today, the CPPS fathers are working as 7 provinces, 3 vicariates and 5 missions around the world. The dream and desire of St. Gaspar coming to India was fulfilled by Father Joseph Montenegro, who sowed the seed for Gaspar's dream. Thus, the CPPS fathers here in India have completed their 25 years of presence, having 89 members in different parts of India, working in different places by taking different social activities and missions. St. Gaspar Vidyalaya is one among those missions. Under this umbrella, the local Aryan children are provided with good education. And not only with that, they are provided with knowledge and are helped to grow as good citizens of the country. As our Rashtrakavi Kuvempu says, wherever you are, whatever you are, first be a human. Yelladaru iru, hegadaru iru, modalu nee manavanagu.